and just like that, Kingdom of Eswatini, you are still tuned into This Weekend Eswatini with myself, Belo Nkosi, of course. And you know what we do? We bring you lovely, lovely guests to talk to you every week. And I just told you, this is about you. And right about now, we have Nontove Dlamini, who is joining us as our psychologist for today. You know, she has said many things to me off screen, and I'd like her to share those things with you. All about love. I told you today you will be hearing the word love many, many times. Firstly, Nondovego, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much, Kosi.
It's very good to have you back.
Thank you so much.
We need a piece of your mind again today.
And I'm in studio today, which is awesome.
Yes, it's just me and you and our people. And they are you are having a love therapy session with them, not me. Please do not involve me in love things.
Okay.
But just to start off with, you are here and you just spoke about realistic love. Firstly, I'd just like you to define love. What is love? Realistic love, like you put it.
Okay. Sanibona ekhaya Eswatini, igama lami Nontobeko Dlamini. I'm an industrial psychologist and holistic wellness practitioner. Thank you for having me today. And realistic love, let's start with Valentine's.
Yeah.
Where did it begin? Where does it come from? Saint Valentine's started the whole thing. It has to do with universal love. Okay. It has to do with godly love. And the kind of love that is not necessarily something that is about a man and a woman or partners. It actually has to do with love, love of family. Like right now, families need love. We've gone through loss with COVID, with the riots, with a whole lot of things that have happened that were traumatic for every family. So that is the love that we need to be practicing, or the love that we need to be showing each other. More than love that is actually based on unrealistic expectations.
Like materialistic.
And when we're looking at mental health, once we start looking at mental health, we start looking at, for example, 8 dimensions of holistic wellness, according to the wellness wheel. So there's financial wellness, psychological wellness, there's economical wellness, there's your spiritual wellness, there's different types of dimensions. And wellness that has to do with your occupation, with your mental health, your as a person. So there's so many dimensions to one person.
And just getting into the mental part, we'll get there, because I people really need to understand this. What does love mean in the mental sense?
Because love?
We love each other emotionally. Hey, but what does love mean?
Ngokwengqondo, I'd say, firstly, this is now me personally.
Yes.
I believe there is love. Luthando lekuthi, as a person, first and foremost, you need to love yourself. Your mental health is important in terms of mentally love yourself. And mental love means you need to be in a position where you reach a balance. Empilweni yakho. Yabona? On all aspects of your life, before you can even begin to put yourself out there. Kuthi manje nawe so vangathi you can give. You can never give what you do not have. You can't pour from an empty cup. And kumcoka lokho ukuthi lokho bamfa bethu sibatshele ngako. Because lo lithando leli, yabona into ococela lithando, lithando lembawula. Bese kunelithando le primer stove, iloku nje futhi. Bese kune electric stove. Kuhambe kuhambe futhi kubuye ukuthi kunelithando leli, yabona le welcome Dover baby. Uyabona? Anathi lithando nini bamfana. So nje all I'm saying is realistic love has to do with, as a person, do not expect another person to do for you what you cannot do for yourself. As a person, do not expect the next person to do for you if that is beyond what they are. The couple spoke about principles.
Yeah.
People have principles, values, and they also have their own visions and dreams of what they want for their lives. And ngiko le social media is a very worrisome self-deception platform. People are living fake lives.
Yeah.
Yes. But truth be told, as in, you know, your mental health also has to do with you taking responsibility for your life. Asiyeke leni to blame social media. Social media ihlalele la ihleli khona. Ibukwa
ngubani?
Ibukwa ngubani? So when as a person, when you actually engage with social media, there's also obsessive behavior at times.
Yeah.
And that is where all these things come from. Lokho ukuthi umuntu abone impilo yalomnye umuntu evengathi naye ngabe so uphila leyo mpilo. That's not life. Asotifune utihlole utibuke. Introspection is so important. Reflection is important. Your background is important.
Of course.
Asotibuke ukuthi uchamukapi, uvelaphi, imvelaphi yakho is also important ukuthi empilweni wena ufuna kuyapi. So your vision.
Yeah.
Your vision board is what you must have. So yes, Valentine's is there. But for example, if your person, if ninegen semjolwen, if you've uthe sisi, the first speaker said Jolani, guys. Yeah, but Jolani. Even Jola, Jola tau heard. And at times, nyegu heard. But we need to know what real love is.
Yeah.
Realistic
and,
love.
And just to add on that, you know, you did speak about psychological wellness.
Yes.
And for partners, especially when it comes to compatibility, why is it important to understand your partner's psychological or their mental wellness? That's not what it's meant to be. Why is it important to understand your partner's psychological wellness?
I would say before you can understand another person's mental wellness or mental state or psychological state, because once you go to psychological state, then that would take an expert to actually assess all of that.
Yeah.
But when as a person, for example, and who is in this relationship, it's important to understand the mental state of a person for your benefit. But you can't understand someone else if you're not looking this way first. You need to look at yourself and your mental state when aqala ngeke ukubone ukungcola kulomunye ungakabuki la kuwe ukuthi wena umenjani, where do you stand. The importance of that as well is I call it actually setting parameters of engagement. When you set parameters of engagement in any relationship, that's how it should be. Once you set parameters of engagement, and I'm talking about have conversations that are difficult to have, the couple that we had, they spoke about the fact ukuthushilo babe wathi don't pretend to have something that you don't have.
Yeah.
Don't say you can do when you can't. The only way for a person to know what you are able to provide and not provide is through parameters of engagement, conversations that are uncomfortable. And when you're a person that understands the fact that awufuni kuyengeka nawe as a woman.
Yeah.
Sine siyathanda kuyengwa. Uma ufuna kasitshela leqiniso ukuthi yati angeke ngibe khona ngaleso sikhathi. We become dramatic about it and we want the person to then say, okay, fine, ngidaba khona, and then they don't show up and then siyakhala
futhi. And disappoint you, yes.
That's called self-deception. Once you deceive yourself, wena, you create a scenario where it leads to self-deception. So the mental health, yakho, first and foremost, before you can even get to the next person, the mental state of a person, is the person even ready to be in a relationship? Are you ready to be in a relationship?
Yeah.
The type of people you attract could be coming from a traumatic experience.
Of course.
So the type of people we attract at times in relationships that may not go well, that also, in a way, has a lot to do with what mental state we are in at the time that we meet those people.
I don't even know what to say. I think you've given them everything. But there's one thing that hurts me the most about love, you know? People claim to be in love. Well, they are in love, or I don't know. But then they end up resorting to things like violence, which is commonly known as abuse. How does that happen if you claim to love someone? How do you get to a level where so vangathi ungamshaya lo muntu lothi bomthanda or uyamthanda?
Okay, so that relates to obsessiveness. Obsessive love, and it's not love, but it's actually obsessive behavior. And obsessive behavior comes from a traumatic experience of some sort. So the person, for example, I mean, it's so unfortunate that we recently lost, you know, a lady that, you know, traumatically, brutally murdered in Nhlangano.
Yeah, sure.
And it's sad that the person that says that is claimed to be her partner is the one that did it. Then you have to ask yourself, lenye inkinga ngikhumula mkhulu wami bekahlalathi inkinga bamfa bami anayo lenfo in a metaphor athi anthumele ligunvani liyobona liyoshaya yabona
research
nyana futhi la ungena khona lo muntu ukhuliswe bobani ukhule kanjani uyayibona lenfo leyo. So for example, people who then become violent, it's many scenarios. It's either the person grew up in a very violent home, grew up in a home where either parent was abusing the other. So some people you find a man that has grown up in a family where the father was the abuser. A lot of some people would say, I would never ever do that.
Yes.
But others would actually emulate that and do that. Because they define
the way of life.
Yeah, they define love like that. Coming to a woman or the other gender, that person would then say, Nagangangshai, shotagangtans. So the person, for example, kule. Yes, it happens. And trust me, don't judge.
No, I'm not.
It happens. Kuthole kuthu kule ekhaya lapho khona babu wakhe bekashama kwakhe. Children will learn through life experience. They become, a lot of the time, what they see. It's so important that also as parents, as families, we work with each other in terms of kwakha an environment that is conducive for ukukhulisa abantwana.
Alrighty, yes. And we are so sorry, our time is up, but I'd like to know more, and where can people catch you and find out more about love and many other things in life, because you're not just about love.
Yes, okay. I have an Instagram, I have a LinkedIn profile, and yes, I'm also a brand ambassador of No Limit.
Alright.
Dressed by No Limit. And Instagram is nondobego_dlamini_11_09.
Alrighty. Yes. Thank you very much for coming to this weekend at Saturday in Nondobego.
Thank you.
And
for
I hope people really do catch you out there. This is our sister. If you want to know anything, well, I don't know if she's my sister.